Hello students and welcome back.
Now we are going to talk about one more flip-flop, and that is JK flip-flop. So in this video we are going to talk about the functioning of JK flip-flop, the truth table for JK flip-flop, and we are also going to implement it using Verilog. So now let us get started. So first of all, the JK flip-flop was redesigned, it was modified from SR flip-flop by Jack Kilby of Texas Instruments. He had studied SR flip-flop and made one simple modification. What was the modification? He said that the inputs will not be called S and R, they will be called J and K as the initials of his name. And whenever the 1-1 condition was coming and we were treating it as the invalid case, now we will use that condition also, and we will say whenever J is 1 and K is 1, then we are going to flip the stored value. In all other input cases, the functionality is same as SR flip-flop as we had earlier discussed. So now, when we discuss this flip-flop, we can see that there are two inputs, J and K. And one more input that we are taking is the present output, Q of T. The highlighted line is whenever J is 1 and K is 1. So you can see if Q of T is 0, then it will become 1. And if Q of T is 1, then it will become 0. Rest operations are exactly the same as we had in the SR flip-flop. Now we are going to implement the JK flip-flop using Verilog. So we are going to create a new design source and we say it JKFF. Then we go to finish and declare the ports. So one input is J, one input is K, one input is clock, and the output is Q. So once these are done, we say OK and wait for the updation. So here, first of all, we should make sure that this is our top module in simulation as well as design sources. Now we double click on the design source and here is our code. We are going to use case statement. And we are going to allocate Q equal to Q and Q equal to not of Q. That means we should first define that Q is basically a register. Then we say always at the rate, you can choose positive or negative edge of the clock, begin and end. Inside this, we are going to write the case statement. So we write case concatenation of J and K. Okay, so it will be the concatenation of J and K. First we are writing end case just to make sure that we don't miss it in the end. Now we define the cases. We say 2-bit binary number 00. This is our first case. Okay, colon. What will happen in this case? When it is 00, we say Q is equal to Q. Now we can copy this and we can create more cases. 01 10 11. So in 01, Q is 0, 10, Q is 1, and in 11, Q is not of Q. So that is all that we have. We save our code here. The schematic is ready and you can see some multiplexers are used because we had used the case statement. J and K are the input, clock is given for triggering the final register which will have the output value, and we are getting Q as our output. Let us check the simulation waveforms as well. So first of all, we are setting clock as a clock of 100 nanosecond. J I am setting as a clock of some other time duration, maybe 130, and K also I am setting as some other time duration, maybe 280, and then we simulate it for 1 microsecond, and what we see now, we expand it and zoom fit. Till this point the output is not defined, the reason being the first case was 00 means hold, we don't know what to hold. Then here once we define 10, but I have to wait for the rising edge of the clock. Okay, decision will be made only at the rising edge. So this is the rising edge. At this rising edge it is 01, so now I have a definite value 0. At this rising edge it is 11, so 0 is flipped to 1. At this rising edge it is 10, so it is 1. At this rising edge it is 01, so it is back to 0. So that is how we can cross check the functionality of our JK flip-flop. So students, now we have covered flip-flops, the next circuit that we have in sequential systems, that is register. We are going to discuss how to design a 4-bit register in our next video. Keep learning. Thank you.